Hi students, the much awaited SBI PO 2021 notification for 2000 plus posts has been released. We at time strongly believed and advised students that SBI PO notification is going to be released. Not only that, we have also cautioned you to start your preparation early. Now see, the gap between the notification and your actual SBI PO prelim exam is about 5 weeks, 35 to 40 days. But don't worry, we are with you. We will help you to plan your preparation. Very soon, we are going to conduct a webinar on 40-day study plan, preparation tips and strategies. Please do attend that webinar to get much benefit and a preparation plan. Now, very quickly, let us look at the details of the notification. We look at important dates, tentative vacancies, number of chances, eligibility criteria, exam pattern. It's same pattern from last few years. How to apply, application fee, and online bank courses offered by time. Very quickly, we'll look at the key details. Now, this is online important dates for this SBI PO 2021 notification. Online registration as well as payment of application fee is from 5th October to 25th October, inclusive of both the days. Now, download of call letters for online preliminary examination first week or second week of November, right? Then online preliminary examination is last week of November, maybe in first week of December. Result of preliminary examination in December 2021, right? Now, main exam call letter download second, third week of December, and main exam will be conducted in December 21, maybe in the last week of December. Then declaration of main exam result in January 22. Call letter for interview in first week, second week of February, and actual interviews will be conducted in second, third week of February. And final result, that is the final merit list, will be released maybe the February last week or March first week of 2022. So these are some key dates. So don't wait till the last moment. From 5th October to 25th October is you can pay the fees as well as you can register online. So do as early as possible to avoid the last moment hiccups. Right, students? Then these are tentative vacancies. If you observe here, including your backlog vacancies, 2000 vacancies, and we have about 56 backlog vacancies. We have about total 2056, huge number of posts for bank aspirants, right? Every bank aspirant's dream is to get into SBI PO, and the notification is released today. So I am saying, please do start your preparation as early as possible. Then let us look at number of chances. If you look at here, general/EWS, number of permissible attempts 4, people with disability, general or EWS 7, OBC 7, OBC people with disability 7, all other categories, there is no restriction. Now you can see here, candidates who have already appeared for maximum number of permissible chances are not eligible. That means if you have crossed your number of attempts or number of chances permitted, then you are not eligible to appear for this examination. Prelim exam is not considered as a chance. Only if you have attempted main exam, that will be considered as a chance. Also, prior to 2015, there used to be single stage exam. So from 2010 onwards, if it is a single stage exam, you have attempted that, that is counted as one chance. If it is prelim and main exam, if you attempted only main exam, that will be counted as a chance, but prelim exam is not counted as chance, right? So from 18th April 2010 exam onwards, number of chances to be counted, right? So this is about number of chances. Eligibility criteria, age as in 1st April 2021, minimum 21 years, maximum 30 years. Education qualification as in 31st December 2021, you should be a graduate in any discipline recognized by Government of India. No mention of any percentage. If you are a graduate, then you are eligible. Now, students who are in final year, final semester, you are also eligible to appear for this exam. Condition is that you need to provide your pass certificate as on or before 31st December 2021. Keep this point in mind. Final year students are eligible to take the test, but they have to provide the provisional certificate of passing on or before 31st December 2021. Let us look at selection process and exam pattern. If you look at selection process, three-tier exam, there is three phases exam. Phase 1, preliminary exam, we have only objective type, multiple choice questions. Phase 2, we call it as main exam, objective type, multiple choice questions plus descriptive test. Phase 3, because of this COVID scenario, there may be only interview for 50 marks, or if everything is settled down, there is a chance of interview and group exercise. In that case, interview is for 30 marks and group exercise is for 20 marks. This is a regular practice of SBI to have both interview as well as group exercises. But due to this scenario, COVID scenario, there may be only interviews also. Right? Three-stage exam, phase 1, preliminary exam, objective type questions, phase 2, main exam, objective plus descriptive, and phase 3 is your interview plus group exercise or only interview for 50 marks. Prelim exam pattern, English language 30 questions, quantitative aptitude 35 questions, reasoning ability 35 questions. Each section is separately timed, 20 minutes, 20 minutes, 20 minutes, overall 60 minutes, 100 questions, 100 marks. Now, two, three important key points here. There are no section-wise cutoff, no minimum cutoff marks in each test area. That means there is no section-wise cutoff. And preliminary exam marks are only qualifying in nature. That means in your final selection, the prelim exam marks are not added in your final merit list. This prelim exam is only qualifying in nature. Approximately 10 times the number of vacancies will be called for your main examination. That's what you are given here. Category wise, merit list will be drawn. Approximately 10 times the number of vacancies in each category will be shortlisted. For example, general has 200 posts. 200 into 10, that means from prelim exam to main exam, 10 times the number of vacancies, 2000 people will be shortlisted for main examination. That means from the top of the merit list, the top 2000 will be picked up. I'm giving an example. Right? Look at main examination. Objective and descriptive. Objective, we have reasoning and computer aptitude as one section. 45 questions, 60 marks, 60 minutes. Each section is separately timed. General economy, banking awareness. 40 questions, 40 marks, 35 minutes. English language, 35 questions, 40 marks, 40 minutes. Data analysis and interpretation, 35 questions, 60 marks, 45 minutes. Overall, 155 questions, 200 marks, 3 hours. Now, as you can see, each section is separately timed. Then one more point which you need to focus here is variable marking scheme. All questions do not carry same marks. Few questions carry 1 mark, few carry one and a half mark, and few questions carry 2 marks. That is why, if you can see here, 45 questions, 60 marks, or how, sir, 40 questions, 40 marks, each question 1 mark. But 45 questions, 60 marks, few questions maybe 2 marks, or few questions maybe 1.5 marks. Similarly, 35 questions, 40 marks in English, and 35 questions, 60 marks in DI, variable marking scheme is introduced. And when you look at this overall, the picture, 155 questions, 200 marks, 3 hours. So you can say, sir, if you look at the overall picture, it's very rosy, right? 155 questions, 3 hours, you can happily more than 1 minute per question. But actually, when you look at section by section, I'm saying not student friendly timings. You need to have enough online practice to adjust to the given timings. Now, see, GK and English, 40 questions, 35 minutes, 35 questions, 40 minutes. Almost the time is double the time, or maybe 40 questions of GK can be answered in 20 minutes or 25 minutes. We have given 35 minutes, 10 to 15 minutes. See, as there is a section wise time limit, even though you save your 15 minutes in your GK section, you cannot use that for other sections. Similarly, English section, 35 questions, can be answered in 20-25 minutes, you have about 40 minutes of time. Another 10 to 15 minutes is, I'm saying, you cannot utilize this time for other sections. Similarly, the two sections, particularly reasoning 45 questions and data interpretation 35 questions, which are more of puzzles and data interpretation, which require more calculation time, these two sections, you have got very less time. That is why overall picture is good, but when you look at section by section, not student friendly timings. You need to be on your toes, you need to practice well, then only you'll be able to get adjusted to the given timings. Now, no section wise cutoff in each section. For interview, 3 times the number of vacancies will be called for interview. Now, for example, if there are 200 posts, 200 into 3, 600, from the 2000, again, top 600 will be called for interview, 1:3 ratio. Then marks obtained only in the online main exam will be considered for shortlisting for interview. That's what I'm saying. Prelim exam marks are not considered for final merit listing. Your final merit list is based on main exam plus interview slash group exercise. This is your final merit list. It's based on main exam marks and interview marks. Negative marking. There is a penalty for wrong answers applicable for both prelim exam as well as main exam. 0.25. That means 1/4 of the marks assigned to that question will be deducted. If it's a 1-mark question, 0.25 will be deducted. If it's a 2-mark question, 1/4 of that 0.5 will be deducted. You have to be very, very careful. Not 0.25 across all questions. 1/4 of the marks assigned to that question will be deducted. If you leave any question blank, you don't know the answer, you left it, no marks are deducted for that. Right? This is about negative marking. Descriptive test, we have 30 minutes, 50 marks. Immediately after objective test, descriptive test will be conducted, and this is an online test. The students need to type on the system. So you need to practice typing on the system. Immediately after objective test, descriptive test will be administered. Then you have only 2 question types, letter writing, essay writing. You'll be given multiple choice questions, you'll be given internal choices. So out of maybe 5 letters, you need to choose 1 letter. Out of 5 topics of essay writing, you need to choose 1 topic of essay writing. Right, students? Then candidates are required to qualify in the descriptive test. Also, the main exam selection is based on objective plus descriptive. The marks obtained in descriptive writing are added in the final merit list. So, students, do not look at only getting qualified in the descriptive test. Try to maximize your score. If you are not qualified in objective test, your descriptive paper will not be evaluated. Descriptive paper will be evaluated only for those students who have qualified in the objective test. Also, each and every mark will count. I am saying, please do not ignore descriptive test. Only letter writing, essay writing. Let us not have that kind of attitude, because if you get, instead of, let's say, cutoff mark is 20 marks, if you, instead of getting 20, if you got 30 marks or 35 marks, that will help you to move up in the merit list. So focus equally well on descriptive writing. Do not ignore. If you are not qualified, you have done fantastically well in your objective test, but you are not qualified in descriptive test, I'm sorry, you will not be called for interview. So, equally important as your objective test, please do practice descriptive test, letter writing and essay writing as well. How to apply? Candidates can apply only online from 5th October to 25th October. You have to register. This is the what you call website, www.sbi.co.in/careers. You have to register there and you have to pay the fee online. What are the prerequisites? That means what are the things you should have in handy before you start applying for SBI PO? One, you should have, as per the dimensions mentioned in the notification, you should have your scanned photograph, your digital scanned signature as per the dimensions given in the notification, and a valid email ID plus a valid mobile number. All future correspondence will be done only to this email ID and the mobile number you provide. So kindly give your valid, that means the email ID in use. Don't give the email ID which you have created at your school level. Again, you don't know the password, again, recovery options, all those will be in trouble, all those will be some troublesome. So try to give the email ID which is in use. Application fees. or intimation charges from 5th October to 25th October, Rs. 750 for general category, EWS and OBC. For other categories, nil. There is no application fee. Then let us look at online classes provided by TYME. So as I told you at the beginning of the session, we are going to have 40-day study plan, preparation tips and strategies. There we will discuss in detail topic-wise breakup, what are the important topics, how to prepare, what is the study plan for these 40 days, etc., etc. Please do attend. We do. Please register and do attend that webinar. Apart from that, if you, what does TYME provide for bank exams 2021 online courses, right? Now we have a 3-month course, 6-month course, 1-year course. There's a difference in fee. 4450, 6450, 8750. No difference in number of classes. Number of classes is 250 hours. This is a comprehensive prelim plus main program. First, we will cover prelim level classes, prelim level portion. Then we will cover your main exam level portion, because hardly 45 days left over for your prelim exam. So first we will focus on your prelim exam syllabus. Let us complete that. Then we will give you main exam classes. Then we have there's a difference in validity of the video. So this is a recorded online course. So 4 months validity, videos will be valid for 6 months. If it's a 1-year course, videos are valid for 12 months. No change in number of booklets, same number of booklets. You'll get 11 e-booklets in all three variants. Validity of homepage, 6 months. That means the number of mock tests or sectional tests you need to take within 6 months. 12 months for 6 months course and 18 months for 1-year course. No change in topic-wise sectional test, but full-length sectional test, mock test here, there's a difference. 10, 20, 50, and mock tests are 30, 75, and 130. Current affair cracker magazine, particularly helpful for your GA section. So 6 issues in 3-month course, 12 issues in 6-month course, and 18 issues in 1-year course. There is no change in number of classes in terms of coverage. There's a difference in validity of videos and homepage and number of mock tests you get. Now, apart from that, we are also going to launch SBI PO specific batches. The details we will come out with a short video of 5 minutes very, very soon. So SBI PO, what is the fees? What are all sectional tests? How many mock tests we are going to offer? How many sectional tests we are going to offer? We will make a video. We will upload very, very soon. But these are general bank exam courses. You can select any one course from these. You can join. Right, students? So these are the key details in your notification. So hope this is helpful, and we from TYME wish you all the very best for your upcoming SBI PO prelim examination. So stay home, stay safe, prepare with TYME classes. Thank you very much, students.